Well, boys and girls, the time has arrived. The day that this video coming out is my 44th birthday, exactly, on this Saturday. So I'm out having fun. This video's been pre-recorded, obviously, earlier in the week, and I'm going to get this bad boy built up. It is AMT's International Transtar cabover 4070A. It's got that big Detroit diesel underneath the cab. Let's take a look. This thing has been newly tooled. They took an old kit that a guy had and made new tooling and brought it back for you. All you big rig builders that are always saying, "Where's something for us?" This is it. AMT, the folks at Round 2 Models, listen to you, and they start producing a lot more kits. So let's take a look at all the styrene, all the tooled up styrene from that original kit. Look at the cab. We've got a lot of work, a lot of sweat, probably some tears put into this. Check it out. You can finally build their own. You know what Chris likes? Pre-drilled holes for mirrors, for handles. Oh, I hate when I gotta try to phantom put them on the sides with glue. That's gonna make final assembly so much easier. Details like that. We have an interior cab sleeve. I've never seen that before. Door panels, got some sleeper details in the back. So that is interesting. I've never seen something where this slides up inside separately. We've got a beautiful tree here of air tanks, air filters, frame supports. We got our differential on there, all molded in a cream-colored plastic, not bright white. Shows up on camera a little better. Let's see if we can subdue some of the shop lighting. Turn it down just a hair so we're not reflecting so much off there. But look at all the intense decal. This is not a first model kit. This is not a second model kit. Pick up the kit now, and after you have a half dozen done and you find you weren't struggling or pulling your hair out, then you can move on to a big rig kit from AMT, because they do require the experienced modeler's hand. Check out the floor pan on that cab over. Textured ribbed flooring. Center console, the big hump over that Detroit diesel. Even though it's underneath the truck, you're still going to hear that thing screaming as you go down the street. They always scream like they're about 3 RPMs away from exploding. Check out awesome bed for the sleeper with sheet crinkle details. No trucker's bed is that neat. I've seen those things. They throw the sheets off, get back to work. We got what looks like some venting. We got the halves of the Detroit diesel. Oil pan. More cross members. Look at the nice bulkhead for the back of the frame with the nice International mud flaps on there. Radiator surround. Big frame rails with the front suspension built in. I like that. Large locating holes. Flip side. We got locating marks for all the parts. Did you also notice something? Parts numbers on the trees. They even made sure to get those in when they designed their molds and everything. Parts numbers. You know where to find stuff. A lot of times one of the complaints about the AMT truck kits, of course, their older designs, was there was no part numbers on the trees. You had to look at the box. Well, now they're actually on the trees for you. Modern design. We got transmission parts, small lines, fan belt, giant drive shaft. Could probably power my real truck with that. Exhaust manifolds coming down. Looks like the back of the cab. Fifth wheel. You notice how most of this isn't molded in chrome? That is beautiful. Don't have to paint over chrome. Don't have to strip it off. They really know what the truck modeler wants. They said, "Give us chrome where chrome should be there, but stop chroming everything under the hood." So they listened. Beautiful wheel set on this thing. Check that out, the detail on there. Got our seats, wheel backs, looks like air brake components, tops of batteries, sides of batteries to build that battery compartment, tank supports for the side of the frame. Take another look at those gorgeous wheels. And you'll get two trees like that, identical, to give us all the wheels we need. Those are some of the most beautiful wheels I've ever seen in one of these truck kits. Really mesmerized by those. A lot of guys go aftermarket resin. You won't need to with the new International by AMT. Let's get out the chrome, the things that should be chrome. Beautifully set up. Transtar logos, mirror braces. Look at that grille. So now we can get all the paint in that grille that we need to without having to do any custom painting. We can lay some black in there. Get that all the way through. Some nice black paint will go right in those sharp edges all the way. Use a Q-tip, we'll do it on video. The grille's molded open, upper and lower. We got our tanks, we got our step plates, we got the Transtar logos, we got the heat shields. Black wash in there, I like that. The headlight bezels, the door handles, grab handles, all those little holes we saw are for those components. We got our cab lighting, which I love it in one piece of chrome because I can tint that yellow and not have to glue a little part on there. Windshield wipers, more grab handles, beautiful chrome wheels for the front end. Mirrors molded in more than a billion pieces are now with their side arms. We just have to hook the other little arm in. We got our smokestacks, air cleaner, front bumper. Awesome. Got the cage work across the back for the exhaust. Look at that. Lovely, lovely, lovely. I'm very happy with this one. Red lights. Got some side glass, headlights, windshield, and amber signals. Leave those in the bag so I don't scratch them too soon. 10 tires. We got one out. I love the little packaging in that. Nice tread pattern. They are Goodyear branded tires. Made out of a very thick rubber. They still should be able to slide over the tire, the wheels, though, when we assemble them. Excellent. And molded in a more realistic-looking rubber. Don't have to do much to those. They're not glossy and shiny, hard, plasticky vinyl. Finally, the decal sheet. Check out all the white striping here, all the white striping there. Navy blue striping, so you don't have to do a lot of masking. We got a billion and a half license plates. We got state stickers. We got company logos. We got New Way Express. What do we got here? Airbond Shipping, Grand Rapids, Loadmasters. Awesome detail. Excellent. Don't see anything for the dashboard. We can work around that. They can't do everything for us. And depending on what state you're in, you almost got all of them covered in a basic international plate. I like that. So excellent, massive decal sheet for the truck. That is everything that's in the box, except we've even got some cool paperwork to show you. All right. Unlike a lot of other kits, but similar to that international pay hauler, we've got paint schematics telling you the paints, telling you how to stripe it. For numerous different versions of the truck, they really did their research. I like that green with the white stripe, don't you? With the green roof. That is sharp. I've been noticing that one, the green on that one, the green and the gold and the black. That's some pretty tight paintwork on that. Not everybody's going to be doing red and black and all that. They give you a whole little brochure about the Transtar. That is nice. If you like reference material, you got to know every single name, every single spec. They give you all that in the kit. They give you all the dimensions, weights, everything on there. And the instruction manual is a work of art. Nice fold-out book, beautiful line drawings, exploded views, really help you get things together. We'll go through here because in the back, they even tell you how to paint it, how to mask it off. Use rubber cement to attach the masks. In the back, you've got your final detail guide. And you've also got paint masks you can cut out and attach with rubber cement. And some ads for some tribe. I built that one. I built that one. I built that one. Does Chris already have this in the shop? Did it arrive early? We don't know, but we'll find out. The Transtar is coming up next. I'm going to get mine assembled and be right back. Well, I'm just going to come out and say it. This is by far and away the nicest AMT kit I have ever assembled for the tractor trailers. The 1/25th scale tractor trailers, there was no struggles. There was no, where the heck does that part go? I don't understand what this is happening. Where do I put this that you can get with some of the older kits? This thing goes together Like, well, they're working on the tooling and stuff. They've redone it, and they've done test assemblies and all that. It just goes together like an extremely modern kit. You've seen me do the new Mobius Fords and stuff like that, the way they fall together. This right here should be your very first big rig kit. If you've done a couple regular glue kits and you didn't struggle a lot with them, this is your first glue kit for a big rig. If you want to build a cab over, this is the one to start with. This will have you smiling the entire time because it just fits. It just goes together. It does what it's supposed to do, and I didn't have to fight anything. Normally, getting this far is a day's assembly process. This was 3 hours, folks. 3 hours to glue all of this together and get it ready for the paint booth. That's it. So let's start looking at things. I've done enough cheering about it because it actually is that nice and that well designed, and the instruction manual is clear, and it was just super nice to put together, and I can see why people were excited about this kit coming back out, that they had found an original kit and based molds off of that and redid it and checked everything out and made sure it worked, because it simply does. So we'll just start going through the sub-assembly because there is a lot to do. We've got our batteries here, 4 batteries, all set up, glued together nicely. Those can be put in the battery box if you want. I'm just putting them on the side. I've glued the battery box together. We'll see that because I don't plan on opening it. I glue everything on this kit solid. We got our drive shaft, steering wheel, and exhaust braces just on one tree so I can get those painted individually. You've seen how I do that before. Same as the dashboard. Got it all by itself. It's not going to go in for a while. I've got to detail the dash. There are no dash decals. I'll show you how to detail that. It's going to be quite simple. And then we will cut it free and glue it in to the interior. We've got our nice little seats. I want to get these painted separately, a different color from the interior. So those go together lovely. They just push together with a little bit of glue. All the parts on this kit, I did not have to shave, slice, adjust, nothing. Everything lined up. It just kept lining up. The exhaust tanks, I wanted to leave chrome, so I sanded the edges and then model glued them together and used the rubber bands from the Texaco kit to glue those together. That Texaco, that Sunoco tanker kit that I built up, that just is a kit that keeps on giving, so those rubber bands are going to be handy. We've got an air pipe here, or what I'm pretty sure is an air pipe that goes off the top of the engine. So I've got that glued together. They want that painted black, and I will do so. We've got our shift assembly, that when we are ready to put everything together, that actually goes up through the bottom of the cab into the interior, so the interior can tilt forward over it. We'll be attaching that, so I will paint that separately and attach that once the engine is attached and the transmission is all attached to the frame. That will be attached, one of the final parts after assembly. We got our radiator lines, we've got our exhaust manifolds. Those will be painted off the truck, detailed, and then attached with super glue. We've got our sleeper bed. I am really not going to get into detailing that sleeper. There's the interior. Once the cab is together, you're not going to be seeing back there, so I'm going to spray this on the inside. Eventually, I'll glue the bed in there just so it's in there, but once this is inside the cab tilts, you're going to see minimal interior detail. But if you want to go ahead and paint all that up and detail it, you go right ahead. I'm going to spray it a uniform color, maybe give it a little bit of a wash for some detail, but otherwise I'm not going to be messing inside the back of the sleeper and all that stuff, because it's simply not going to be seen on my display, and then I don't worry about it. But the show guys or the super detailers at home, you can see how beautiful that is with the rolled up curtains and everything and the interior panels. You go ahead, detail that to your heart's content. Make yourself happy. We've got the interior floor pan. I've got all my pedals glued in place, the giant brake, clutch, fuel. We're going to be painting the interior, doing some detailing. We got a little chrome ring we got to put in here. Our shifter's going to come up through the floor there. That's all set. We've got some bracing. We've got the cylinders for the tilt cab. Those are all set up, so we're going to be doing that. We've got that ready to go. These are the large pins that it will use to flip up, and hopefully that works well for me. Everything else has been going well, so I've got high hopes for it. So that is the nice interior with the steering column. I want to spray that all together and hand detail it with brushes. The nice big radiator system, that's what that was if I would have looked closer. It's a double thickness radiator. Fan shroud, that's going to mount right between the frame rails after I get that painted up. Now let's start looking at all of this. We'll switch sides on the desk so I can see it. This is a lot of loosely stuff put together, so don't go, well, this isn't put together. Stop complaining. Got the cab, needs no real work to it. We've got all the pre-drilled holes, so what I'll have to do is get the cab painted, assembled in final assembly, add my decals, my decals of choice, and then with those pre-drilled holes, I'll just poke through the decals with an X-Acto knife and attach all my final trim pieces. That's the way I like to build. So that will be how that goes together. So the cab just needs to be sprayed. The engine is not pushed all the way in. It actually locks into four pins in the chassis beautifully. I just have it laying up here on top so I can demonstrate where it goes. Same as the wheel and tire package is not snapped on because these do snap into place. I don't want to put them on yet. I want to get them painted separately. I've got a color scheme in my mind that I've seen online and then adapting it to my own likeness. So those front wheels look lovely. The rear wheels are just as beautiful. Just nice assemblies going on. I love this cream-colored plastic. You can see it so much better. High-quality plastic used. Check out this exhaust system and how well it lines up. I mean, this I've got a hand paint. This I've got a hand paint since it was already there. I wanted to glue it in solidly with model glue. Lined it up with the exhaust, and that's it. All that exhaust is all done. It lines up into the frame. You're not going to fight it and wonder why this doesn't line up, and that doesn't line up, and this doesn't line up. Nope. All works perfectly. And then it just slides out. It's going to attach with super glue with these large points here. Look at this. It just snaps right in with a little drop of super glue on each one and on the bottom there. And your exhaust system is attached. Your air cleaner is attached. Your air intake through the cleaner and all that. It's just so nice. And our large manifolds will come up in the bottom and attach up underneath in the holes there. I'm just really happy. I'm not fighting this kit. I'm not having a bad day with it. The engine, gorgeous. Large locating pins for the exhaust to go on later. Filters and lines. Belt and pulley system. These large pins are where it will attach into the frame. No guesswork, no nothing. And just check all of that out on that big Detroit diesel. Parts to be attached later, of course, are left off. Lovely, lovely, highly detailed assembly. Now we get to the frame. All of this is going to be painted one color. So I attached it all now. I will hand paint the air cleaner. They want it chrome. I can paint it up with my beautiful tester silver. That will look just fine on there as the air cleaner assembly coming off. The detail on this thing, everything keys together. See these large holes here? That's where our engine will attach, and it lines up beautifully when I spread it apart to stick it in there. The axle's got large attachment points. There's no mystery position for the front axle like it is on a lot of them. We've got all these little tanks and air tanks and levers that all go on and will get painted together. The radiator should mount, and it does. Look, it just falls in. That's where that'll mount. It lines up beautifully. When you build the two frame rails, these two large braces in the back, key the entire frame together and hold it tight while you're doing your assembly. The brace back here, the axles all go into large holes, the shocks go into holes, the airbags on the back for the suspension, everything keys itself in, locks itself into place. You can't screw it up. You don't have to run and measure corner to corner to make sure it lines up. It's just going to go together beautifully and line itself up. When I attached the rear bumper and the mud flaps, I was worried, is this going to be cockeyed? Nope. Everything lines up and it sits flat. It's all great. The steering you can build as an adjustable steering if you wish. You can melt the pieces together as they show. You can adjust the steering. You can still steer it. I did not. I glued it in place, but that is an option for you. So, that's everything. That is an amazing amount of work. Almost 10 minutes of a subassembly show off. The longest we've ever done because there's so many awesome things to show. I am going to hit the paint booth right now and I'll see you over there. Thank you. I'm cruising down the highway set at 55 old double nickels on what so far has been the absolute easiest model truck build I have ever done of this scale, this size like this. It's just really, really well done and easy to work on. This is kind of how it's gonna look. Still gotta put the tanks on, gotta put the diamond plate on, gotta do some other stuff on the truck, of course. Needs all the trim, needs the decals, all the fun stuff. But we're getting to the final assembly point, so I'm gonna stop now so that when I come back from this, we'll have the final. But the cab is ready to go, ready to have the interior put in. The headlights just look like that. They're a little like cloudy on the tree. But the glass itself is crystal clear. I did not use the door glass. I just chose to leave the windows open so you could see inside. But the windshield wraps around. You can see how that Mod Podge completely disappears on the inside. How it wraps around for the smoker windows, the vent windows. And then I did the rubber trim around it. The rest will be done with decals and grille inserts and all that kind of cool stuff on there. So the cab's ready to go. The chassis looks awesome. The exhaust is going to go on like that. Let's get that up and out of the way. If you notice, it's a little less shiny. On the fuel tanks, the diamond plate, and on the exhaust, I decided to flat coat that with a clear flat. Doesn't matter the brand. Just spray it. It will tone down your chrome, and I like the look of that. Some of the other stuff will remain chrome, but I did take it off there. Now you can see the exhaust bolted up. You can see the airline here. You know this airline is a friction fit. It just slips into the pin and on the pin on either side, and that's not going anywhere. The radiator is a friction fit. Glued in the radiator lines. The shifter mounts on the side. There's a slot for it in the frame down there. The wheel and tires are just a snap fit, like a snap-on toy. They don't roll, so your model won't roll off the shelf. The chassis looks awesome. We got the engine on there. We got it all decorated. I'm not doing any weathering on this at all. I don't want to beat it up. I don't want to scratch anything. This will be more of like a day six truck. It's not perfectly factory excellent, but it's in nice shape. It's a nice shape for the model on the shelf. We've got the interior here. Now, I haven't glued any of it together. It's just press fit together because once I get it together, you're not going to see it. I'm going to try to take a picture of it from the outside, but we'll see how it gets when we're all done. But the dashboard pops off the front end like so. We'll glue that in place. And you can see that lovely dashboard all done up. Got it all set. I don't know if that's perfectly scale accurate. Followed the manual as much as I could. Got the one decal on there. Otherwise, I hand painted everything. Did the wood grain in the center console. That will go in and look awesome. The top is a nice khaki. We got the interior sitting like so. You can see right in. We got our khaki seats, we got our baby puke green interior to go with the bright green outside, and you can't see into the sleeper at all. It's just dark back there, so I didn't bother decorating anything back there. And underneath, made sure it stayed black, so when the cab flips up, it is black underneath there. These are our cylinders, the rams for the inside of the cylinders to tilt the cab forward. The cab pins here will go into the frame. Right where these large pins are. They're not super tiny. They're not glued on. It's one solid piece molded in there. That's what I like for that design. So that goes over the top. And then we'll just push our cab right down over. This part here of the interior is just press fit on for now. So you can see inside, I got the door handles in, got that baby puke green interior color, and then that's the inside of the cab. We got the rubberized mats, we got that green, got the black with the chrome in the center, and our steering and pedals. Very basic, very much a work truck from International for me, not a big customized rig. You'll notice when I was assembling the wheels and tires, I didn't bother painting the very back of the wheels. That's where I stuck them onto the board, because the brakes on the inside, you can see, cover that all up. So you can't see it. I didn't bother trying to redo any work on it. So the exhaust goes in so nicely still and just lines up. We'll just press them together tighter and glue them into place with super glue. That's what I'm going to do. The final assemblies, get the decals on. I'm going to decide which ones I want to use on this rig. And then we'll attach all the little chrome parts, all the little chrome stuff that's to go on the rig is the grille. You saw how I picked out the letters, the horns, the heat shield, the grab handles, which all have holes, the pogo stick on the back and all that. That will all be added once everything's glued together, once the decals have dried, then I'll add all the chrome trim and we will be done. The final reveal. People have been waiting years since they heard about this thing coming out. AMT's 125th scale International Transtar cab over 4070A. What a beautiful kit. I have to just say that again. If every big rig kit went together this nicely, this easily, and this quickly, and final assembly went this well, I would build three of these things a month, because this giant kit doesn't take any longer than a car kit. 10, 12 hours over 2 days, and you're all done, not including paint drying time or anything, but what a lovely kit, and everything fits, and it pushes together, and it clicks together, and the handles go where they should. You might have to take a razor knife and open up some of the holes once you have paint on them, but all the parts go on. And let's talk about the mirrors. These are the best mirrors I've ever seen in a big rig kit in my entire life. The main part glues onto the body with holes. The mirror itself just kind of snaps right onto the side. It just, you don't need any glue at all. In fact, you can see they still move a little bit. Awesome. It's got a pogo stick on the back included. The fifth wheel will move if you want it to. We've got full suspension. We've got lights. We've got marker lights. We've got overhead lights. We've got the air intake, smokestacks. Beautiful molded open grille, which they've engraved nicely to let you very easily paint the black stripe in it. The decals lay down like a beauty. I used just a little bit of decal solvent. They hugged right down. They come off thin but durable. They weren't stiff. They didn't crack. Nothing. They didn't give me a fight or anything. You could, of course, spend a lot more time perfecting the kit, get rid of every tiny little seam. I don't worry about that. This thing is gorgeous the way it is. I love the way those wheels look with that black undercoat, and then the white misted over the top gives you beautiful shadows. That grille and everything goes together lovely. The interior is quite visible through the front windows, so it is nice that I spent some time on that. You get massive set of decals. You get the white stripes, the blue stripes for the high waist stripes around the center, and you get the large white stripes for around the very lower end if you want to do it the way I did. I love this thing. I love the reference material they give you with the kit. They throw in all the cool stuff that I showed in the beginning, all the cool pictures and the paint codes and everything. They give you this nice big reference book. You can see more of it when you buy yours or in the beginning of the video. Awesome. All the spec sheets for the Transtar, so all you informationophiles out there that have to be perfectly factory accurate, you can do it, and this is such a nice kit. And the gusto on this is that, and I'll try to do it, well, I might stop the turntable dead because it is a weak turntable with a big glass mirror and the truck, but the tilt cab actually works. It works right on camera. I didn't have to fight anything. I gotta get the box out of the way though, because it's too long once that's on there. You can see under the hood completely. You can see under the cab. You can see all the lines, and you can see the shifter for the transmission, which links up through the other linkage there. It's all on the kit and it looks amazing. The radiator lines, the air hose, the exhaust, everything lines up and it looks right, and I didn't have to work on it forever. To put it back down, we'll see if I can get it down. I just have to push the shifter a little bit forward and to the side. Let's see here. Of course, it's on camera, so it's not going to do it great. There we go. Nope. Come on. Come on. There we go. And right back down it goes. So when you display that at home, you can display it either way. You're not trying to do it on camera with the truck spinning around. We'll put that beautiful vintage look box back there. So that is it. That's the International TranStar Cab Over 4070A. It is a beautiful model kit. I hope that Round 2 decides to do this with a lot of their model kits. Revise them, improve them. The sales will increase because I highly recommend this as a first model truck kit. I do. You're going to have such a fun time with it. You're really going to enjoy yourselves building it up. Highly recommend it. Thanks to Round 2 Models for sending this over. I will link down in the description, as always, where you can grab yours. And thank you for watching the workshop. Build for you. Have fun. Smile. And remember, it's just a hobby. We'll see all of you at the next review.